Joining us right now in studio is the comptroller of the state of Maryland, Peter Francho, who has never been shy about his criticisms when necessary. Comptroller, let me ask you, and I'm going to let you get to everything you want to get to. We have plenty of time. What initially hit you when the president came after Congressman Cummings and the city of Baltimore? How did it hit you?
Well, first of all, I like Congressman Cummings, and he's got a lot of integrity and a lot of power, and he can certainly take care of himself. So I felt badly for him, but not that badly. What I felt badly for was Baltimore, and Baltimore needs a champion. We need William Donald Schaefer back here. We need Anthony Williams, who took over after Mayor Barry down in Washington.
Control board, yep.
When they were at the pit bottom of corruption and bad reputation. We need someone leading the city who can champion for it. As far as I'm concerned, I'm happy to come in and temporarily fill in to give my two cents about the city of Baltimore, because I've traveled all over every nook and cranny. I've worked with Reverend Al Hathaway on his big project. I've worked with T-Ball Mannequin, who did Our House, and has so many other things going on around the city. And I've worked with just hundreds of good people that are doing great things in Baltimore. And when the president, who frankly reminded me of Archie Bunker on a bar stool, made those comments about Baltimore City, Baltimore City can't defend itself. So here I am, happy to be a champion for the city. Do we have infrastructure problems? Do we have public safety issues like you just noted? Of course we do. But those can be dealt with if we all work together and roll up our sleeves and get the job done.
I know that you are committed, and once again, people don't know what you do off camera. I know. I talk to people like a Reverend Hathaway, and things you do outside of the light of a camera. But, Comptroller, what we have faced since the National Guard left here in 2015 is a red blood sea of carnage. We have seen schools where you had to stop them. You've talked about this. You had to close them because you have icicles hanging from the classrooms. You have people in coats. And the only reason we knew about any of that is a teacher, Aaron Maben, former NFL player, tweeted out pictures of this. What I'm saying is we don't have people who are looking at this crisis and acting like it's a crisis.
I agree with you that this is an opportunity. Every challenge and every crisis that occurs, such as this one where the president goes off like a drunken Archie Bunker and criticizes the city of Baltimore unfairly, in my viewpoint, although...
And by the way, he's the president for Baltimore City, too. He's not just the president. He's also the president for Baltimore City.
Yeah, so every time that happens, there's an opportunity. And the opportunity, as you noted, is to pay some special attention to the particular sore points. I would be more than happy to support increased police presence, either the state police or some other entities, to be placed in the city. Why do I think that's important? Do I think that the public has a great relationship with the police? Not necessarily, but we've got to, as you say, stop the crisis right now. And the best way to do that is to have law enforcement in a visible way.